speech. Question number 5. Which term of the following sequence is A 2, 202, 4 up to so on is 128. So here we have to suppose the nth term will be 128. Okay. And also find out first term as well as common ratio from given GP. So find the value of n. It means which term. It means find out the value of n. So from given GP, A is equals to 2. R is equals to 2 under root 2 upon 2 because second term upon first term. Okay. So we get under root 2. Let us suppose nth term will be 128. Okay. Therefore, An is equal to, we can write A into R raised to N minus 1. So here given that N term will be 128. So 128 is equal to A. First term is 2 into R is equal to under root 2 raised to N minus 1. Now divide by 2 here. So we can write 128 divided by 2 is equal to under root 2 raised to N minus 1. So we get 2 6 are 12. 2 4 is 64 is equal to under root 2 raised to n minus 1. Now see, what is our question? We have to find the value of n. So we have to make the same base. Okay. So find out reference of 64. Okay. 64. So we can write 2 32 is 2 16 is 2 8 is 2 4 is 2 2 is and 2 1 is. So we get 2 raised to 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 raised to 6 gives 64. It means under root 2 raised to 12. Yes or no? Under root 2 raised to 12 gives 64. Because on right hand side of root 2, we have to make same way. So we can write under root 2 raised to 12 is equal to under root 2 raised to n minus 1. Now comparing power. Okay, as base is same. So we get 12 is equal to n minus 1. Therefore, the value of n is equal to 12 plus 1. Therefore, the value of n is equal to 13. It means 13th term will be 128 of given GP. Now see B under root 3 up to so on is 729. So same as above, we have to suppose n term will be 729. Yes or no? So we can write n is equal to 1729. Okay. Also find out first term and common ratio from given GP. So first term is under root 3, it's very clear. Common ratio is given by second term upon first term. So we get 3 upon root 3. It means 3 gives root 3 into root 3. Yes or no? Upon root 3. So root 3 will be cancelled out. So we get under root 3. Now see, we know that an is equal to a into r raised to n minus 1. Therefore, n term is 729. So 729 is equal to first term is root 3. Common ratio is also root 3. So we can write root 3 raised to n minus 1. Now see, here root 3 raised to 1. So root 3 raised to 1 plus n minus 1. So we get under root 3 raised to n. Yes or no? 729. Same as above. What is the question? Find out the value of n. It means we have to make same base. So find out factors of 729. Okay. 729. Now see. It's divisible by 3. Okay. So 3 2s are 6. 3 4s are 12. 3 3s are 9. Again, it's divisible by 3. So 3 8s are 24. 3 1s are 3. 3 27s are 81. 3 9s are 27. 3 3s are 9. And 3 1s are 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, 3 raised to 6 will be 729. But here we have to write under root 3. So we can write under root 3 raised to 12. Simply twice of 6. Under root 3 raised to n. Now comparing power because base is same. So we get the value of n is equal to 12. Therefore, 12th term will be 729. Is it clear? Okay, next. See, 1 by 3, 1 by 9, 1 by 27, up to so on, is 1 upon 1 times 683. It means we have to suppose the n term will be 1, 9, 6, 8, 3. Okay. Let us suppose n will be 1 upon 1, 9, 6, 8, 3. Also find out first term as well as common ratio from B1 GB. So first term is 1 by 6, very clear. Common ratio is given by A2 upon A1. Second term upon first term. So second term is 1 by 9 upon 1 by 3. So it gives 1 by 3. Same. So A and R will be same. Now see, we know that An is equals to A into R raised to N minus 1. Now put the value of A is 1 upon 1, 9, 6, 8, 3 is equal to, first term is 1 by 3. Okay, so 1 by 3 into, and second term 1 by 3 raised to N minus 1. So same as above. See here 1 by 3 raised to 1 and 1 by 3 raised to N minus 1. So here base is same. So we have to add power. So 1 by 3 raised to, we get 1 plus N minus 1, it means 1 by 3 cancel out. So we get 1 by 3 raised to power N. And left hand side we get as it is 1, 9, 6, 8, 3. Now again I will repeat, we have to find the value of n. So we have to find factors of 1 upon 1, 9, 6, 8, 3. Okay, because we have to make same base. Okay, so whenever we have to find factors of 1, 9, 6, 8, 3, so we get 1, 9, 6, 8, 3 is equal to 3 raised to power 9. So we can write 1 upon 3 raised to power 9 is equal to, on right hand side 1 by 3 raised to power n, it means 1 raised to n will be 1 upon 3 raised to power n. Now taking gross product, so we get 3 raised to n is equal to 3 raised to 9. Now comparing the power, so we get the value of n is equal to 9. It means 9th term will be 1 upon 1, 9, 6, 8, 3.